Hey guys, it's Navjot Singh Jadeja. Welcome to today's lecture on Introduction to Computer. This video is part of C Programming as well as Programming for Problem Solving lecture series. So in today's lecture, we're going to talk on what is computer. So as we all know, a computer is an electronic device, but it has certain characteristics, and because, as I said, this is part of a course, you need to understand what does it do. So it accepts data, it stores data, it retrieves the stored data, processes the data as and when required and as we desire. There is an output which we get in a desired format, and the major components of that computers are hardware and software. So what is in hardware? Hardware is the thing which you have in front of you. So I've got a computer in here, all set of computer components. So we have a monitor, which is an output device to display all the things which we do is in the processing. We have the speakers, again are the output device. The sound outputs are given through speakers. We have the keyboard, which is an input device. So we provide all set of inputs via keyboard. Then we have a microphone, mouse and CPU. So based on the characteristics, we have the input-output devices in here and a complete set of a computer. So this is the hardware. And then there is software. Software is a computer software or a program, which is nothing but a set of instructions which are given to computer to perform specific task, right? So how does this work? What is the software is? Software takes some input from the user or from the system, processes it through the system, and then gives an output. So this is the basic idea about what the softwares are, what the hardware is. Then we have categories of software. So basically, when I say software categories, there are three categories. One is system services, second is utilities, and third is application. So if I were to talk about system services are nothing but operating system or any other system which or the software which gets the system usage. Utilities are the services which are required for communication between the system services and the application software. The simplest of the example is those who would have installed the drivers, the graphics drivers, the printer drivers are the utility softwares, whereas application softwares are the one which actually work on specific applications. So just like you know, Word is for typing and you know, it's an editor for Word documents. Then Excel is for, you know, maintaining the records. So those are the application softwares, whereas system services are known as system softwares, and utilities are the one which are specific purposes, right? And then we, you know, understand how it works. In the core or the center, we have the hardware. Hardware is the, you know, all the components, the hardware, the touchable components. Then we have the system softwares to work as in the platform to get the best out of the hardware. As I said, operating systems are the system services. They are the system softwares. On the top of it, we have the application softwares, different specific application softwares like Word, Excel, your gaming, etc. So these are the application softwares. And then, you know, utilities are the one which are also part of it. They are the one which are, you know, driving the hardware to perform specific tasks. I gave you the example of printer drivers. They are the utility softwares, right? And on the top of those layer, you are the user, people who are using the system. So that comes as in the outermost layer. So this is how the, you know, overall connection of the different components of the computers are. Then let's see one important topic as far as the examination is concerned, as well as in general in understanding of how the computer works. So this is known as block diagram of computer. This is very important because if you understand this, you will be able to use this very understanding in your further part of the programming. So we have an input device, we have an output device, and in between we have a CPU. CPU is the, you know, the central processing unit of the computer. So it's not the one which you refer to as CPU. A lot of people, especially in you know, Indian background, Asian background, call the cabinet of the computer as in the CPU. Guys, that is not the CPU. CPU is the central processing unit within that cabinet, which performs all the tasks, and that is divided into two components, which is arithmetic logic unit and the control unit. So arithmetic unit is the one which performs the mathematical functions, whereas control unit is the one which performs how, you know, control logic works. So we'll see that in the detail in the further lectures, what are the arithmetic operations, what are the control operations. And in order to perform this, we need a set of memory. So we have a memory unit which comprises of primary memory as well as the secondary memory. So when we say memory unit, it has the primary memory such as RAM and ROM, and the secondary memory, which is hard disk and other utility storages. What is the difference between primary and secondary? Primary memory communicates with the processor directly, whereas secondary memory requires primary memory in order to communicate. The examples of primary memory are RAM, ROM, cache, and as I said, the secondary memory is the hard disk or your external storages. So this is the general block diagram of computer. Input devices are all the devices which are used to provide some sort of input. It's not only keyboard, it can be a microphone, like I'm using it right now to record. And the output devices include the output or the sound speakers or the printers, etc. So this is how the block diagram of a computer looks like. Then we talk about the applications of the computer. So if we understand application of computer, it's very wide and diverse. It includes entertainment, it includes the communication, it includes the text processing, it includes the video which you're watching, that is the World Wide Web. It includes image processing, the video which I'm working on. It includes the numerical and data processing. So everything which you are seeing surrounding yourself right now are parts of applications of the computer. So maybe in the replies to comment, you might tell us more on applications of computer after watching this video. So that is it for the introduction of the computer. In the further lectures, we'll see how different components of computers play a part. Plus, we'll also be seeing the concepts of algorithm, flowchart, etc. for you to understand how the computer works. And then furthermore, we'll go into the programming depth. Thank you so much. Have a good day.